Hi friends, in this video, I am excited to share with you a fantastic trick for making selections super easy. With this technique, you can effortlessly cut out any subject from even the toughest, trickiest or busiest backgrounds. Whether it's a busy street or even a complex pattern wall, this technique can help you make perfect selections every time. And it's get even better if you have ever struggled with selecting messy or curled hair. This technique can help you extract them seamlessly. No more frustration or wasted time trying to get the perfect selection of those hard to select areas. So, are you ready to get started? Let's dive in and learn how to make selections like a pro. We will be working with this specific photo, and it's important to take a close look at it. Before starting, you will notice that background and subject colors are almost identical, which makes it a bit more difficult to achieve a perfect selection. However, with the technique we will be using, we can make the process easier and achieve the results we want. To follow along with the tutorial, you can download the sample photo from the links provided in the description, or please check the pinned comment. Alright, let's get started with making our selection. First, you will want to select your preferred selection tool. Personally, I like to use the object selection tool as it's quick and accurate. Next, click on select subject option. This will automatically create a rough selection around your subject. Keep in mind, this is just a starting point and we will need to refine it further to make it more precise. It's important to note that if any areas were missed during this automatic selection process, we will need to manually add them in before moving on to the next step. This will ensure that we have a complete and accurate selection. Great. Now that we have our rough selection, let's move on to refining it further. Go ahead and click on Select and Mask in the menu. In the Properties panel that pops up, you can choose your preferred view to work with. This is really just a matter of personal preference, so pick the one that feels most comfortable for you. For me, I usually choose overlay as it's the easiest for me to see. The most important feature in Select and Mask is the Show Edge option. So make sure to tick the checkbox next to Show Edge to enable it. This will allow you to see the edges of your selection more clearly and refine them to perfection. That we have enabled the Show Edge option, it's time to fine-tune the settings to get the perfect selection. Let's scroll down to the Edge Detection section in the Properties panel. The most important setting here is the Radius. This is the key ingredient for making perfect selections. When you move the slider, you will see the mask edge starts to show up. This is because we enabled the Show Edge option earlier. To set the optimal radius, you need to find this sweet spot for your selection. For example, if you set the radius to 10 pixels, you will see that the selection preview covers all the hair. That's our cue. We shouldn't go overboard or be too conservative with the radius. It's like a mathematical calculations that we need to get right to achieve the perfect selections. Personally, I like to keep the radius at 8 pixels for this image, but you can experiment and find what works best for you. Use smart radius if image contains both soft and hard edges. It means that some parts of the image may be blurry or out of focus, while others may be in sharp focus. In such cases, use the smart radius option. It's a good idea. It allows you to adjust the radius for different parts of the image based on their edges. However, in this case of the image we are working on, the entire subject is in same focal length. Therefore, we don't need to use the smart radius option and I can leave it as it is. And also, please note, if you are in hurry or want to quick results, you can use this refine hair tool to make your selections more accurate. However, keep in mind that this might miss some tricky areas. So I prefer to skip it and stick with the basic settings to ensure a more precise selection. We don't need to make any changes in these settings as the default options works perfectly fine. After this, go back to the Show Edge option and disable it. When it comes to refining the edges of the hair, It can be a little bit tricky, but don't worry, it's not that difficult. What you want to do is select the refine edge brush from the toolbar and adjust the brush size to a size that is appropriate for the edges of the hair. Start painting along the edges of the hair. Be careful not to overdo it, as this can lead to an unnatural looking selection. The goal here is to select all of the hair strands and make sure that the selection is as clean and accurate as possible. And if you make a mistake or accidentally select something you didn't intend to, simply switch to the erase tool and remove any unwanted areas from the selection. You have completed the refining the edges of the hair. It's time to look at the rest of the image. Take a moment to check if the selection is looking good or if there are any areas that need to be fixed. In this case, it seems that the lower part of the subject's body looks perfect already, and I don't want to mess it up. Once you are happy with the selection, it's time to output as a new layer. Simply click on OK. We have successfully created a new layer with the subject cut out from the background. Now, to continue with the process, we need to add a solid color adjustment that complements this subject. You can select any color of your choice that looks good with the subject. Once you have chosen the color, add a solid color adjustment layer to the document. I'm quite happy with the result. It has almost done a good job. However, some thin hairs are not so visible, especially in contrast areas due to color fringing, which can be a bit frustrating. But no worries, we can fix it easily. To fix this, we need to hide both the color adjustment layer and subject cutout layer. Hold on the Ctrl or Command key and click on the background copy thumbnail to activate the selection. Now select the background layer and again go to Select and Mask. Now turn on the Decontaminate Colors option, which will help us remove any color fringes around the subject. Then lower the amount to your preference until you are satisfied with the result. This time, output the selection to a new layer with a layer mask. Click OK. And we are done. Now you have a perfectly cut out subject with no missing hair. Good work so far. We are almost there. Now to make the final touches to our image, first drag the solid color adjustment layer beneath the new cutout layer. Then, since we don't require the background copy layer anymore, let's delete it. Next, let's add our exclusive gradient. To do this, click on the gradient fill adjustment layer and click OK. In the gradient fill dialog box, change the style to radial and make sure to check the reverse option. Finally, click OK to apply the gradient. And that's it, we are done. Take a look at the before and after images and see how far we have come. Selecting a subject with complex edges and backgrounds can be a daunting task, but with the right tools and techniques in Adobe Photoshop, it can be accomplished effectively. In this tutorial, we have demonstrated the step-by-step process of making a perfect selection of a subject with a complex hair and background using the Select and Mask tool. I also showed how to refine the selection further and add a solid color adjustment layer to complement the subject, followed by a gradient overlay to give the final touch. I hope that this tutorial has been helpful to you and that you have learned some new tips, tricks. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please subscribe to our channel for more tutorials like this. Thank you for watching. See you again in the next video. Take care.